صلى الله عليه وسلم as he gets towards المدينة he goes to a small house where أم معبد the mother of معبد is and الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم goes in and asks her if she has anything to feed them but she says no and he sees a pale sheep and he tells her do you mind if I milk the sheep she said I don't know it is you could see it's very pale and I have no milk so الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم told her it's okay and he started milking the sheep and brought a lot of milk out and he drank and Abu Bakr drank and gave some and then again he filled the jug again for her family so subhanallah الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم for he left not like some of the guests they want to eat all the food and leave things empty he filled it made sure it's full for the people who's coming after subhanallah so الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم filled it again for Abu Ma'bad so when he came back Umm Ma'bad said there was two men she didn't know it was Rasulullah and she described the husband asked her to describe him and she describes the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam as he's not tall he's not short his friends treat him nicely and respect him when he talks people listen and she describes this is the only description of a Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam we have till today because as Amr ibn al-As says I could not describe a Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam because I could not look into his face long enough because he was so bright and so overwhelming I couldn't look to describe him subhanallah so Umm Ma'bad in this journey describes the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam And what does the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam do when he first gets to Al-Madinah? He builds a masjid. And not like our masjids today where it's only for prayers and we lock them. The masjid is really for the community. It's a place for the government. It's a place where the poor used to sleep at night. It is everything to do. So it's a community center, not like us today. It's a place where we pray and we separate the men from the women. And we close it because we're afraid it might be robbed or something like this. Subhanallah. It is a place for the community. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought the community together. And he made brothers between the Muhajireen and Ansar. And the best example is Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, a brother to one of the Ansar. And this person from Ansar told him, I will give you half my money and I will give you everything. But Abdul Rahman ibn Auf says, thank you. Just show me where the market is and I'll start to do business. And Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, when he left Mecca, he was one of the richest. And yet he left all his money in Mecca for the sake of Allah. And when he came to Al-Madinah, he came with nothing, but he built his wealth again. He built his wealth again that there is one time, Sayyidah Aisha says she was staying at her home and she felt Al-Madinah is shaking. So she asked, what's happening? They said, this is a caravan for Abdul Rahman ibn Auf coming. So she says, رحم الله عبد الرحمن بن عوف. لقد heard, I have heard, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on عبد الرحمن بن عوف. I heard the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, يدخل الجنة حذوة. He goes to heaven crawling. So when he hears this, he says, yes, I will give all this caravan for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because he is very rich. That's why it takes, even though he's one of the 10 that was promised al-Jannah, but because he's very rich, so it takes a long time to account, to make him accountable, but he gave all for the sake of Allah. And we notice when he became a brother, he didn't take the money from the Ansar. No, they lied and realized this is a privilege. Rather than abuse the privilege, he told him, fine, just show me where the market. And he starts going out to work. Rather than we see nowadays, somebody goes as a guest, leaving the people working, and he's staying at home enjoying himself, subhanallah. Rather than see sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it says, let me go out and work. And they became brothers in Islam.